Hi, I'm Handy Mora from Easy Online Video Tips. Today's video, I'm going to show you a powerful tool to do your basic video editing on your PC. Now, I'm a heavy Mac user myself, but I do use a PC on occasion, and I know how frustrating it is to edit videos on your PC. So I've discovered this product fairly recently. It's very affordable, it's around $40, and this product is called the Sony Vegas Movie Studio HD. To me, there are five steps to editing your video when your intention is to put it online. The first step is to cut out the sections you don't want. The second step, maybe stitch two or three clips together. Third step, add some text. Fourth step, add some audio, usually in the form of an intro in the beginning or an outro at the end. And last, you want to publish it to an online service. Put it on the web, either through YouTube, Facebook, or host it privately, whatever you need. So keep in mind that there are other tools out there and they may work well for you. So you can still learn something from this video even though you're using a different video editing software.
When you first open Sony Vegas Movie Studio HD, you're prompted to enter a project name. So I'm just gonna call it My Video. Hit Next. I'm in America, so I'm gonna hit Next. Now, the output type, if you're not sure if you have a high definition or a widescreen camera, I suggest sticking with the Internet Video SD. So I'm going to click that, hit Next, and my project is all set up. Hit the Finish button. I'm going to quickly show you the layout of this program. On the top left here is your folders that contain all your files. On the right is the preview of your editing or in the files that you were looking at, and on the bottom here is what's called a timeline. Now, a timeline basically is made up of individual tracks. That's the technical word for almost like a layer or a component of the video. So for example, you have a track for your text, one for some video overlay such as graphics, one layer or track for your video itself, voice, music, etc. So I'm going to first show you how to bring in a file into this project. So I'm going to go to my folder, the videos folder, drag the MOV file, and I'm going to take it to the third track, 1, 2, 3, the third one that says video. And notice that there's two bars. There's a video and a voice, because my video has me talking in it as well. So it separates the video and the voice into two different tracks automatically for you. So if I drop it in and let go, I see my video. Now, the first step we talked about is one thing you'd like to do is you want to cut your video. You want to cut out a section of your video. So if I, for example, want to start here, I can press enter, it can start playing and listening to the audio, and if I press enter again, it stops the bar, the play bar. Now this gives me an opportunity to cut the section. So I find the easiest way to cut is to actually split up your track into different segments and delete the segments you don't want. So let me show you what I mean. So let's assume I want to split this clip into two clips. So I'm going to press the S key. Then I'm going to press enter again. I'm going to let it play for a bit. And then if I press enter again, it stops. Now I'm going to press S. Now what this did is it set two markers where it split my video clip into 1, 2, 3 sections. So to delete, I simply click on the middle section and hit the delete key, and it's gone. Now this leads me to my second point, which is in video editing, sometimes you want to stitch two clips together. In our case here, I divided my clip and I removed a section out of it. Now I want to connect the two clips together. So I simply use the left mouse button, I click and I hold, and I drag the mouse until I get close to the second clip, and it automatically snaps, it automatically connects to the previous video. And the third thing you want to do when you're doing video editing, most likely you want to add some text. For example, you want to add the URL to your website. So this is very easily done. So I'm going to leave my video and voice tracks alone. If I go up here where it says text, this is a whole new track dedicated to my text. So if I want a text to appear right here, in this point in time, I right-click my mouse button and I say Insert Text Media. Now I highlight this existing text, just delete the sample. I'm going to change my font size to something a little smaller, and I'm just going to start typing www.easyonlinevideotips.com. So you can see on the right side what it looks like. So now my text is done. I can change the font if I like. I can highlight, change the font. But the nice thing is I can also place it wherever I want. So if I click on the placement tab and I click, notice the icon changes to a hand. If I left click and I hold the button down, I can move it. I can position the text anywhere I like. I'm going to position it right on top here. Once I'm happy with it, I'm done. I just close the window and the text appears up here in the text track. Now, if I want the text to stay longer, I can simply move the mouse over to the edge of the clip, left click and hold and drag to make this text extend all the way to a specific period of time. So the fourth step is, in some cases, you want to add some music, maybe some background music, or maybe you want to add some music to the intro of your screen. So the music, again, has its own track. So there's a track called music down here. So I'm going to take my MP3 and drag it down to my music track, and I want it to start from the beginning. So once I drop it in, the music file is there. Now, you can control the volume of the music. This bars on the side here will adjust the volume of each track individually. So I want to turn my music down to very soft to make it a background music. Now, with music as well, you still have the same capability of cutting out parts of the soundtrack. For example, if it's in the intro, you only want it to play for 5 seconds and you want it to cut out. So I'm going to move my cursor here, click on the music track, and press the S key again. So similar to what we did with the video. Now we have two sections to the track, and I'm going to delete the rest of the track. So I only want this small segment of music. Now one little hint here is you don't want the music to abruptly end. You want it to kind of fade away. You don't want it just to cut abruptly. So if you hover the mouse to the top corner of that track, you see a little curved icon. If I press the left mouse button and drag it, you see a little curve, a little line. And this is what's called a fade. So it's going to fade the audio down so it gracefully ends the song. Okay, now we're done. I'm going to save my video. And I'm ready to publish the video online. So my favorite thing about this software is it lets me directly upload to YouTube. And it prompts me for your username, your password, a title, enter a description, choose a category. This is identical to what you normally do when you upload your videos to YouTube. Add your tags. Tag 2. Now, for broadcast options, you always want to leave it public, so you want people to see it. And the render quality, I would start off with normal, depending on how fast your internet connection is. Normal is pretty good. Normal is great, actually. It's, for most purposes, it's fine. You don't need to go any longer. If you want and you notice the video is not very sharp, you can try rendering the higher quality version. For my case, I'm going to start with normal, and then I'm going to hit the upload button.
As you can see, editing video is not that difficult on a PC if you have the right software. Now, although Movie Studio HD is a great tool, you may have some issues with certain file formats. So don't forget to read my blog post below to find out some great tools that will help Sony Vegas Movie Studio HD detect the different file formats. Also, if you're looking for royalty-free music, I have a link down there as well. I'm Handy Mora from Easy Online Video Tips. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to sign up for my free newsletter where I'll email you free tips when they're available.